गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। ओम भवताप प्रणाशिन्ने आनंद घनमूर्तये ज्ञान भक्ति प्रदायिन्ने मातस्तुभ्यं नमो नमः। जय मां। I have heard complaints from people saying that the audio is very soft. I'm trying to work on that. I don't know what to do. And the moment I get some more instruments or something, equipment, I will probably try. But at the moment, I'm working only with my iPhone, you know, camera. And I don't know why people are not able to hear properly, because on my Mac and iPhone, things are very clear. So I don't know, maybe it's different instruments that is doing that, you know. So anyway, let's see what happens. So I'm sorry that, you know, some of you can't hear properly. And the only thing you can do is just hook it onto some speaker or something and maybe it'll work. So anyway, in the last video, I'm trying to speak a little louder. In the last video, we were talking about, I was telling you about Swami Nirgunanandji. At that time, he was Shanti Vrat. So, like, you know, he was always with Ma, writing letters for Ma. So when he would come out of the room, he was a new lad kind of thing in the ashram. And there were a lot of veterans over there. So he would come out of, the moment he would walk out of Ma's room, he wasn't allowed to talk to anybody like he was in Mon. But the moment he would walk out from the room, he would look like this on the right, on the left, and, you know, look at people that I'm somebody, you know. That attitude was there with him all the time. So now comes a time, this just went on, okay. Now comes a time, I'm cutting it short. Now comes a time when Ma had, suddenly Ma had somebody coming to meet her. It was a new boy, okay? And he was from some other ashram. He wasn't from Ma's ashram or anything. And he was a new person who was also educated and everything. So Ma showed a lot of excitement of that, about this new boy coming. Now slowly, slowly those feelings of, you know, insecurity, jealousy, you know, that envious nature that everybody has started coming up, you know, with Nirgunanandji. He had a problem. So Ma started giving a lot of importance to the new boy that had come. And Nirgunanandji was put in the sideline, a little bit in the sideline. Now, initially when Nirgunanandji came, Shanti Vrat, he was given a room next to Ma. Now, when the new boy comes, she gives a room which is closer to her than Nirgunanandji. So that also was like a major problem with his emotions, you know, that I was her favorite and now somebody else has come as a favorite and I have to take a back seat. So this is human nature. You see, this is what Ma does, these exercises for all of us, you know, so that we improve. And she teaches us a lot of things. So this other boy got a room which was closer, so close that he could just open a connecting door and enter Ma's room. He didn't have to go from outside and open the main door or nothing like that. A connecting room. Whereas Nirgunanandji was a little far away. So he felt that this is a new boy. इसको कुछ आता वाता तो है नहीं, कहीं बाहर से आया है और माँ इतनी इंपॉर्टेंस इसको दे रही है, तो what is this, you know? And when this new boy came, Ma would make him sit in her room. He should call him, make him sit in the room and chat with him, and you know, things like that was happening. So, and Nirgunanandji was always Nirgunanandji was asked by Ma to do the chandi. And she said, you do a kind of an anushthan. And anushthan means you have to be nirjala. When you do a puja, when you do a path and all that, you have to, in the morning when you get up, you can't even take a drop of water till the puja is over. And once the puja is over, then you do your own cooking and then you eat. So everything has to be done before 12 o'clock, like I had mentioned, I think earlier also. So he was given this anushthan. Now, वहाँ पे क्या होता था कि once the puja is over, he has to do the tikka. He has to go to Ma's room and do the tikka on her, give her prashad, नैवेद जैसे चढ़ाते हैं भगवान को, तो माँ को देना पड़ता था और वो टिक्का लगा के only then the puja was finished for the day. So he was busy doing the anushthan and that means not going near Ma at all in the whole morning. And Ma was sitting one day. What happened is he was knocking on Ma's door and he had the tikka in his hand like this, you know, on his finger. And he's in mourn, so he can't say anything. He just has to knock. There was no answer. Again he knocked. So from inside Ma said, "Arey ruko," you know. So he opens the door and she says, "Dikhai nahi deta. Main baithi hu iske saath baat kar rahi hu. Dikhai nahi deta. Abhi hum log busy hai. Bahar khade raho." You know, now that was a lot of humiliation for him, that suddenly he was the favorite and now he's become like a second-hand stuff, you know. So he stood outside and he says, "I was like dying inside, you know." And he stood outside till this conversation got over between the boy and Ma. Now the boy's ego was getting inflated. Kasi, you were an old hand, like, you know, you had come sometime before me and now I am Ma's favorite. So his ego was starting to get inflated, you know. So he sat over there for some time and all that. And then again, Nirgunananji knocked and came in and Ma then culminated the meeting with the boy and told the boy to go. Okay. The boy gets up, looks at Nirgunananji like this, that see, now I have taken your position, you know, that kind of an attitude. Oh God, I tell you. This is a constant thing that happens with human beings, isn't it? So he went away. Now when he went, he just rubbed his shoulder. He rubbed it on Nirgunananji's chest or something and he just and pushed him like that and went. So Nirgunananji was obviously feeling very bad that some new chit of a boy has come and he's done this to me, you know, whatever. So he kept quiet. He says, "Meri halat aisi thi ki main ek second mein ro padu, aisi halat thi." But he controlled himself and he was standing with the tikka. So Ma says, "Arey, tikka baad mein bhi ho sakta tha." So, you know, Ma was bent on doing that to him. He went inside and quietly looking down, he says, "Ma tikka," you know, like he just pointed the finger like that. And did the tikka on Ma and he turned to go out. Now he was standing almost for an half an hour or something outside, you know, I don't remember exactly. And he was also, he hadn't had anything, not even a drop of water. And the moment he turned, Ma called him back and said, "Arey, tumko pata hai, ye ladka bichara subah se nashta nahi kiya, kuch nahi, mere saath baitha tha, baate kar raha tha mere saath. तो उसको सब मैं समझा रही थी, बता रही थी, तो बेचारा भूखा है वो, तो सुबह से कुछ भी नाश्ता नहीं किया, तो एक काम करो, तुम वो अंदर के रूम में जाओ, you know, then I will translate it in English, अंदर के रूम में जाओ, मेरी चौकी के नीचे है ना बहुत सारे मिठाई के डब्बे हैं, तो उसमें से कुछ आधा होगा, कुछ क्वार्टर होगा, कुछ पूरा होगा, तो जो आधा अधूरा है या पाव है या जो भी है वो नहीं लेना, पूरा डब्बा वहां से निकाल के ले आओ और वो लड़के को जाके दे के आओ, वो बेचारा भूखा जो है." Nirgunananji says, "Here I am since morning, I haven't had a drop of water and she's not thinking of me and she's asking me to get that box out and go and deliver it to this boy upstairs who was acting so smart with me and he's like a junior. Why should I go doing all these things for him?" But he said, "Ma has said so." So I was like dying inside and I quietly went into that room and I went under the chowki, the bed, Ma's bed, and he says there were thousands of boxes over there, hundreds of them, and now I had to open each box to see whether it is half full or half empty or whatever, a quarter or whatever, because Ma had said, "Get a full box of mithai. Don't get half or don't get quarter." So he dived under the bed and he's hunting for a full box, okay, of mithai, of sweets. So it takes a little time, doesn't it, to hunt, you know, whether this is, so every box he was opening was either half or quarter or whatever. Finally, he was struggling with that and he hears from the other room, Ma saying, अरे क्या कर रहे हो इतना समय, ये आजकल के लड़के हैं ना, कुछ भी काम जल्दी नहीं होता. She says, such a lot of time. Nowadays, these new boys that enter, they don't even know what to do and they can't do anything quickly. That's what Ma was saying. He says, I was under the bed and I'm saying, what is Ma up to? It takes a little bit of time for me to hunt, you know, a full box. And why is she doing this, you know? So he says, doesn't matter. I was just quiet. And I said, okay, I'm going to just do what has to be done. Finally, he found a full box. He brings the box out and shows it to Ma. So Ma said, go and give it to him upstairs, you know. So, he hadn't done the tikka till then. Sorry, when he entered the room, immediately Ma said, go and get the mithai and deliver and all that, you know. So the tikka was still left. And until he did the tikka, his puja was not over. So he says, he brings the dabba outside and he tells Ma tikka, you know. Ma says, wo baad mein, later, first go and deliver the box upstairs. So he had to do it. So he takes the box and goes quietly upstairs. I think he was on the first floor or something, or somewhere, you know, close to Ma's room. Maybe first floor and then he comes down. I don't really remember. So he goes and knocks on his door. He takes a little bit of time to open the door. Finally, he opens the door and looks at Nirgunanji like this. That, see, you had to come to me. So Nirgunanji just pushes the box on him and he takes the box and again gives that attitude and shuts the door on his face. And he says, oh my God, and he comes down. He says, by that time, it was like somebody had taken a knife and cut me in pieces, you know. He said, I was just finished. I was so humiliated on every angle, you know. Comes down, goes to Ma's room and stands again with the tikka. And he says, Ma, tikka. So Ma says, theek hai. And then he did the tikka on her. And he said, I just wanted to run away from the room. Because he said, in a second, I would have burst out crying. So I didn't want to do that in front of Ma. So he turned around and started going towards the door. As he went halfway, from behind, Ma said, Shanti Vrat. And he turned around. And she says, come here. So he came. Then she said, sit down. So he sat down. And he was looking down and he sat down. Ma put a hand on his head. You know, she just put a hand on his head. And he burst out crying. And Ma just looked at him and said, lagta hai na? Lagta hai na means it hurts, right? And he couldn't control after that. He just cried and cried and cried. And then Ma just told him, now go. So this was a lesson Ma taught. It was so unbelievable that you had an attitude when you entered. You were doing the same thing that this boy was doing, right? The new boy came, he did the same thing. You were doing the same thing when you entered, but you didn't realize what you were doing. You had an attitude, you were trying to show everybody that your ego was so inflated. You were trying to prove to everybody that you were the greatest and you were a special child of Ma. So this was the whole exercise that Ma made him go through to teach him all this. He said, as soon as I walked out of the room and I came out, I suddenly realized everything, that I had become such a huge balloon that if anybody pricked, I would have burst, you know. It was that big an ego. And he says, that's when I learned my lesson that this does not work. So see, Ma has so many different ways of doing things. After that, of course, he was with Ma all the time. And that boy also, very shortly, he left the ashram and went away. So this was an exercise for basically Nirgunananji to become Swami Nirgunananji, what he is today. You know, that time he was Shanti Vrat. So Ma does all kinds of strange things, you know, to teach you so many different things. And it is true that, you know, she's very soft, very gentle, very everything, very compassionate. But when it comes to teaching you, no, she is tough, you know. So that's one incident that I remembered, and I thought I will narrate this to you. The whole thing is mentioned in the video, you know, in Swamiji's video, and he's narrated very beautifully because obviously he went through the whole thing. So he said it in a lot of details, but we don't have the video right now. I do have it, but I'm not allowed to post it. He said no. He says, main mar jaunga uske baad karna. I said, what does that mean? But that's what he wants. So we have to respect that. Okay, now my points. I'm going to go through it. You know, there was a very nice incident. I have a friend. This was, I think, in 1978-79. She has a son who's got Down syndrome. You know, it's a special child. So she had once come down from her building, and that time I didn't know her. You know, I got to know her only in, I think, maybe 1998 or so, 1996-97, something like that. You know, I must have got to know her, and I'm talking about 1979. She had this Down syndrome child, and he was just 4 or 5 years old then. And she had taken him downstairs for a, you know, like a little walk. And she was carrying him and walking, you know, just outside her building on the road, in her, you know, garden or probably her road. There comes a lady who comes and stands in front of her and says, oh, you have a special child. It's a Down. So she said, yes, he's got Down syndrome and whatever. So she says, I have a suggestion for you. Why don't you go to Pune and meet Ma Anandamayi? Oh, she had never heard of Ma Anandamayi, and her husband never believed in any of this. Okay, her husband never, like, koi bhi bole Mahatma ke paas jao ya ye yogi aaye hain ya ye koi bade koi log aaye hain, whatever. He would just say, no, we don't need all that. You know, we will do our duty and look after our own child. We don't need to go to anybody for help. You know, we are not going to do that. So the husband never believed. Now this lady tells her that you go to Pune because Ma is pretty old and fragile now. Because see, this was 79 and Ma left in 82. So she was told to go, and she says, tumhara beta theek ho jayega. Your son will be fine if you go and meet Ma Anandamayi. Now she had never heard of Ma Anandamayi, so she went upstairs to her husband and mentioned. And yeah, after saying this, she was looking somewhere, Bridge, you know, turned, her name is Bridge. She looked here and there for something, and when she turns around, this lady has disappeared. So she says, "Arey, that lady was talking to me, and where did she go?" There was no lady there. She went upstairs and told her husband that this is what happened, and I met this lady, and she told me to go to Pune with the child, and what should I do? So he says, "No, we don't need to do any of this." So that chapter was over. Now comes 1998. See, this is Ma's Leela. Ma had called her in 1978-79 to Pune Ashram. But she could not follow the call. You see, she couldn't understand what Ma was saying. And comes 98 or 97-98. When she used to come home for my father's satsangs, you know, she used to come to learn from him. And that is the time she got to know about Ma Anandamayi. And she said, then one fine day she called me up and she says, my God, do you know what happened? I said, what happened? And she narrated this incident to me that, you know, there was this lady, and I'm pretty sure that it was Ma who had, Ma had sent somebody because she disappeared. And I wish I had heard that call and I had listened to her and I'd taken my son there. It would have made a huge difference, but I didn't understand anything. And she says, today I come to your house and I'm hearing about Ma Anandamayi. And will you believe it? Today she's a Dikshit of Ma. She's taken Diksha from Ma's ashram. You know, in her whole family, she comes from a very spiritual family. So her whole family, they have Dikshas. Okay, her brother, her in-laws, not in-laws, her from her father's side, everybody's got Diksha. Her father was a very spiritual soul. Her grandfather also, everybody, you know. And they all would tell her, tum diksha kyun nahi leti ho? And she says, mujhe zarurat nahi lagti hai, mujhe nahi leni hai koi diksha, you know. So all her life it went on, everybody in her family have diksha except her. She didn't have it then. And then she comes and meets us and meets my father. And then she's convinced that she should take Diksha from Ma's ashram and from Ma. And today she's a Ma Dikshit. So see how things happen with Ma, isn't it? That's that for today. Jai Ma. Om Bhavatab Pranashinne Ananda Ghanamurtaye Jnana Bhakti Pradayinne Matastubhyam Namo Namaha. Jai Ma, Jai Ma, Jai Ma.